In this video, we'll be discussing multi-class neural networks. In particular, we'll talk about multi-class neural networks. We'll also talk about multi-class neural networks in PyTorch. And then we'll give a brief introduction to deep neural networks. So in multi-class neural networks, we're trying to predict multiple classes. So for the missed dataset, we're trying to determine if our class Y is a digit between 0 and 9. So multi-class neural networks function pretty similar to regular neural networks. Instead of adding a logistic function in the output, we add a neuron for each class we want to classify. And these neurons have their own set of parameters. And then to classify the actual class, we simply look at the output of each neuron and select the maximum value, exactly like softmax function. So I like to think of it as follows. We have our softmax output, and instead of putting the input feature x, we input the outputs to the hidden layer into the softmax function, and then we classify it like a regular softmax function. So we can also use this for two classes, and the only difference is we'll have two outputs. And I usually use it this way because I can use a lot of pre-built features and functions I used before for the two-class problem. But again, that's up to you. If you have a two-class classification problem, you can use a softmax function or the logistic function. So we take our input, we pass it to the hidden layer, and then we pass it to the output layer with multiple outputs, and then we apply the same methodology we use for the softmax function. So let's see how to build a multi-class neural network in PyTorch. So here's our custom module, and everything looks pretty similar. We have our input dimension, and then we have the number of hidden layers denoted by h. So we take the input to our hidden layer, and what we're going to do is we're going to construct a second layer. And dout will be the number of classes. In our last output, we won't apply a sigmoid activation function. We can also do it using the sequential module, where dout is the number of classes we'd like as an output. So we can load the data set, just like the softmax example, and we use the cross entropy loss, identical to the softmax example. And just to note, our torch sensor has to be long, and has to be n, not n by 1, like in logistic regression. And we still have to convert our missed data set to a 1D tensor, or vector, with 784 dimensions. So we construct our neural network object, or model. The first parameter will be the number of input dimensions. The second parameter will be the number of neurons. And the final parameter will be the number of classes. And then we'll optimize it using the SGD optimizer. We'll create a train loader object and a validation loader object. And then we'll train the model using a function. And the training process is identical to that used in softmax function. So refer to the softmax video to see how to build that function. So you can also go deep with the neural networks, and this means we're just adding more hidden layers. So everything's the same. We take our input feature, and we pass it to the first hidden layer. And then the output to this hidden layer is passed to the second hidden layer until we get to the final. And for this particular case, we have 5 hidden layers. And each hidden layer doesn't necessarily have to be the same size. In this example, we have 4 hidden layers. So before we get to build neural networks with more hidden layers, we have to see historically why these networks didn't function before. And that's it for this video.